Good afternoon, Marco.
Good afternoon.
How is everybody? How are the players? Because you've had some issues with illness recently.
Yes, we had last week. This moment, we just have Ivan Cavaleiro out. Shalobas started working with us this week as well, and some players not in 100%, and tomorrow I'll decide what will be the best solutions for the game.
So in terms, of those players who were ill, like Tom Kearney, for instance, is he now okay, or is he somebody that you still need to assess?
No, Tom will be back, yeah.
Great. I know you said after the Preston game that you didn't want to make excuses for that performance, but could one of those reasons have been fatigue? Are the players tired?
It will be the easiest way to analyze the game for many people. For me, it's not that way. Of course, we lost 2 points in one goal, with one goal that must be disallowed. Unfortunately for us, was not the first time that away from home we lost points and with goals like that. Against Coventry was with one penalty as well that was not penalty at all. The easiest way is to go to start to speak about the referee or to start to speak about fatigue, but it's not my way. It's not the way that I like to be to analyze the games, and it's not the way that I will look to improve our performance as well, and to improve my and to develop my players. Of course, was a tough week for us in terms of preparation. Many changes in the match day as well against Derby, and after the 3 days after to prepare the Preston game as well. But we will not be excused. We have to look for ourselves what we can control, and to prepare the next game. Because I made some changes. Some players, they didn't play the 3 games in a week as well. Was not just one. I can tell you that Danish didn't play the other two in play. Mika Seris just play 2 games as well. Tosin as well. Okay, it's not an excuse for us. Of course, if you talk about the three forwards that you play, Mitro and the other two, the two wingers, they played the 3 games. Mitro had the issue with the illness that, as Harry Wilson as well, they did a big effort to play, but will not be the excuse for us.
But having been unhappy with the schedule, the fact that you had the game on Wednesday night, the early kickoff on Saturday, how do you feel about the fact that you're now playing a very big game on a Friday evening rather than a Saturday afternoon?
That's the schedule, but I think will not be an issue for us because we had the week to prepare, and you prepare in a normal way the game. I think it's tougher when you play Wednesday night and you finish a game at 10 p.m. and after you start early kickoff on Saturday. If you ask me, of course, we respect and we know why, but if you ask me if it makes sense, in my opinion, it doesn't make sense at all. You do this. It's a big risk, not just in terms of performance, but in terms of to take some injuries with some players as well, because they are not recovered at all and ready to play again in the same intensity. Of course, you can change 8-10 players if you have, but it's not the same thing. But playing on Saturday now and playing on Friday for us is a normal thing, and we cannot complain about nothing. We had a normal week to prepare the game, and we will be ready to play.
I know it's only December, but how significant could the result of this match be?
3 points there is the way we look to the game. Of course, it's against a contender. They are a contender, clear, like you are as well. And it will be not the first time that you play against a contender. We did against some teams as well, and we performed, and we want to do the same against Barmouth. Of course, the team that will win or take a positive result will be different motivation, will be happier, of course, but will not decide absolutely nothing at all. Nothing will be. We are not even in the middle of the season. We have a big marathon in front of us.
This will be Scott Parker's return to Craven Cottage. He played for Fulham. He then, of course, managed them very recently. How worried are you that he might know as much, if not possibly more, about some of your players than you do?
I'm worried. Not at all, not at all. Of course, what I want from my players and for everyone in this football club to look to the game like we are doing along this week, okay? Will be a tough game for us because the quality of the and the Bournemouth, the way they are playing, the way they are managed as well, and nothing more about it. I want, and what I hope, and I want to see tomorrow all of us, all my players, all the staffs, everyone in the same page than myself, like we did so far this season. Nothing more. Will be a match against Fulham against Bournemouth, and not with the names in the middle.
What have you made of Bournemouth so far this season? Because they seem to have been dropping points while you've been dropping points, so neither side has sort of managed to pull away.
Yeah, but let me know one team that don't drop points in this competition. I think both teams, they are doing fantastic season for you. Definitely, definitely. You are really happy with the season that we are doing so far. Of course, I want always more. My players, they wanted more as well. You are demanding really from ourselves as more as you can, because we want always to improve all the situation. But looking to the table, and if you are looking that in some games you drop points because you don't play alone and you have the opposition side, they do their best. I think we good example is what Preston did last weekend in the second half. Wasn't our best performance. I can say that we didn't perform good enough, to be honest, but we have to give credits to them as well, because they played in a way that they put the things difficult for us. And dropping points in this competition, not just in this league, I think in all the competitions as well, and I think it's not something that you have to look, okay, they are in trouble or something like that. It's part of the competition. But we are really happy with the season so far. Tomorrow we have another game, a tough game. I expect an open game and both teams trying to play to win the football match. And this is the main thing for us. Everything what we've done before, of course you are happy. The points that you dropped, of course you wanted something different, but nothing to do now. We already analyzed and you have to look forward to the next one.
I know you said it's the two teams against each other, not the two managers against each other. But are you aware that this was a fixture that your players were particularly looking forward to because of how Bournemouth have performed so far this season, and also because Scott Parker will be their manager?
I think maybe you are more looking for that than my players, to be honest, because you already asked me twice about that. Maybe you are more concerning about it than myself or my players, to be honest. And first, I didn't say that was, I said that was Bournemouth, Fulham against Bournemouth, not both managers, one against the other. I didn't say that. I didn't say that was not Fulham against someone else. It's Fulham against Bournemouth. I didn't speak about manager at all. About the other situation, I have to answer to you in the same way. Looks more that you are more concerning than us or my players. No one speaks about the manager or something like that. We did our normal job during this week. We prepared the game in the same way that you prepare against Preston. All the situations are normal here. We didn't change nothing. I didn't see nothing in my players that they have changed as well. And of course, we are planning everything in the same way that we did the games before.
And finally from me, are Fulham and Bournemouth the teams that will be automatically promoted this season, do you think?
Another good question, but I can't answer to you. Is your words, not mine. Of course, if we'll finish tomorrow the season, looks like, to be honest, because the points we have. But unfortunately for us, the season just will finish on begin of the May, and we have a big marathon ahead of us, and we have to keep work really hard. And the contenders are there around, and some of the others, they will start to be closer to the top. I don't have doubts about that as well. And you know, I think we know Championship really well. And just have a look for the last 10 seasons, so don't waste too much time. Have a look for the last 10 seasons and see what's happened during these 10 seasons, and if someone in the beginning of December can have the promotion guaranteed or not. I think no, for me it looks impossible to talk about it. And as always, we look for each game in the right moment, and for us it's Bournemouth the most important game because it's the next one.
You've been in your role a few months now, and it's been a real up and down time with injuries and illnesses. But you sit top of the championship. How would you look back and sum up your first few months in charge at Fulham?
I'm really pleased to see the way you are dealing with all the challenges in front of us, and we. Was the way we started was tough. I can't lie to you because we arrived late. Like we lost the first 15 days of the pre-season, we lost it. We just arrived here with the players working with Stuart, and all the situations that happened this football club in the beginning of the season wasn't normal for a club that wants to get promoted straight away, and for a club that wants to plan everything in the right way, wasn't a normal situation, I have to tell you. And fortunately for us, for a new manager inside, we just have 4 weeks to prepare the first match. And even during that period, some players, they arrived late, some players and key players for us, they were injured as well. And of course, it was a process. And I have to tell you that the players, they were, from the first day, really open and with the right mindset to learn and to understand quick what will be our philosophy and what we want, our idea and our model to the way we wanted to play. And they are doing it really, really well. Of course, wasn't everything perfect because it's really tough to achieve that. Sometimes you are working in one football club 2 and 3 seasons and it's difficult to achieve that perfection that you want to see. But I have to... I have to be happy and pleased the way you are doing with it, with some injuries, some problems and all that situations. But I think we are doing well and you have to keep doing it this way. And the only way that I know in football is to keep working really hard, to keep with high motivation every single day to come here at Motsu Park to work and to improve.
Marco, when you look at this season and Fulham and Bournemouth, it's like the movie Rocky, you know the boxing movie with Sylvester Stallone, because effectively Fulham at one point, you know, you were a few points behind and Bournemouth looked invincible. Everyone was talking about their unbeaten run, but you fought back and you're still punching.
Because you are competing in championship, and you know championship, you can't have nothing guaranteed in your hands. If you remember, we started really strong the season. When we had the first break, everyone is talking about us. And after the second break, everyone was talking about Bournemouth and possible in the next month, someone will talk about or West Bromwich or Stoke or Coventry or even Sheffield United if they start to getting good results, because it's championship and, you know, it's really tough competition. If you are not always switched on, every club can punish you and can take points from you, and you have to be always at least almost in your best level to win football matches. Of course, what we did until the last 9 games, winning 7 in a row, is not a normal thing in this competition. And you did it, you achieved it because the players, they believed and they worked really hard to achieve it, and with some very good performance as well. Last 2 games, we didn't win. It was 2 tough games for us as well. And we dropped some points. Our opponents, they will drop points as well. And I think it's championship. It's like that. And you have to be always to analyze the last one and to go to the next one. You are talking too much about a competition between 2 clubs. For me, it will not be like that. And the future will show that will not be like that.
Statistically, you've got the best striker in Europe in your front club, in Alexander Mitrovic. I mean, you know, it's going to be a real slog for him, but is tomorrow the opportunity for him to show that he is by far and away the best striker outside of the Premier League in this country?
Why tomorrow?
It's the biggest game, isn't it? The biggest game of the season.
Yeah, for you. For you, it's the biggest game of the season. For us, it's another game. is another game. They are 3 points. I don't see this game different than I saw the game against West Bromwich, to be honest, or against Stoke when you play against them. When I play against Stoke here at home, Stoke, and as we were both in the first position on the table, and we play against them, and was a tough game for us, and good that we won and we perform well. We don't see the game in this way. I respect your opinion, of course, but we don't look to the game in this way. We look to the game against a tough side that is there on the top with us, a team with a lot of quality, individual players with high quality, technical quality as well, in my opinion. Good organization as well, but the biggest game of the season, definitely not. We don't look in this way. It's a game that we want to win, definitely yes. It's a game that we are fully motivated, definitely yes, like we were against all the others before then. This one, no one can win 7 games in a row if you are not fully motivated. No one can be 9 games unbeaten if he's not fully motivated as well. And we don't look to the game in this way. About Mitrovic, if he is to a good game for him to prove something. No, Mitrovic has to prove every single day for me that he's in conditions to play in this team and in conditions to keep helping us with these goals and to keep helping this football club. And he has to prove this every single day. And after the match day will be just a consequence of the work he can do during the week.
Just one more from me, Mark. I know you don't really like answering questions about the return of Scott Parker, but you know the atmosphere is going to be we're really electric with the feeling of the Fulham fans towards him. Is that a good thing? Because effectively you can tell your team, play off the atmosphere, Friday night, under the lights, on TV, you know, it's going to be loud, it's going to be energetic, go start quickly.
Yeah, well, the game will be like that. The game will be like that. I don't have doubts. You know, I have to remind you, because for sure you were there as well. I think you were there in the game against West Bromwich. It was the early kickoff on Saturday, and the crowd was there, was electric, was behind us every time, and was really tough to them because the way you played and the way the crowd was behind us, the atmosphere they create in our stadium, the noise there. And of course, if they can replicate that tomorrow, will be fantastic for us. Will be fantastic for us because, as I said, always, if they are always behind us, the good and the bad moments will be stronger at the end, and they can be the 12th player on the pitch. Definitely, definitely that. And what we can ask them is to help us again and to create a tough atmosphere to them and to push our team forward, because after we have to do the same on the pitch and to make them proud.